Hey everyone, today we're going to be learning more about the Inset tool inside a Blender. To get started, I'm going to press Shift A, and then under Mesh, I'm going to choose Cube, then I'm going to press Tab to go into Edit Mode, A to select everything, and then I'm going to right click, and then choose Subdivide, and in the bottom left hand corner, a little menu called Subdivide will appear, so I'll just left click to open it, and I'm going to change my number of cuts to something like 8. And now we have a little bit more geometry to play around with. I'm going to press 3 on the keyboard to go into Face Select Mode, and I'm going to scroll down to this option here called Inset Faces. Then I'm just going to left click a face here, and then I'm going to press Shift Control left click to select this entire set of faces here. Now what I can do is I can left click this tool here, and now when I hold down the circle, you can see that's going to allow me to inset. I'll press Control Z to undo that, because some of you might already know that we can also press the I key to inset, and we don't need to be in the Inset tool to do this. I'll right click to cancel that operation. At the top here with the Inset tool selected, you can see we've got a few options, such as Outset, Individual, Offset Even, Offset Relative, and these options can be found without using this tool in the toolbar as well. So I don't like to use the toolbar, so I'm going to left click my select box again, and this time I'm just going to press I. And when I left click to save my inset and open my Inset Faces menu, you can see we've got all those options I was talking about here. Thickness was just how much we moved our mouse, so you can see as I increase or decrease this, it allows us to manually adjust the edit we just made. Then we have this parameter called depth, and this will actually push our inset in or out. So you can see it's pushing this along the y-axis, either inwards or outwards. And if you want to reset it to the default, you can just turn it back down to zero. Next we have individual. Notice when I left click this, we'll have a bunch of faces that have been inset. And if I alter my thickness here, you can see what it's pretty much doing is it's taking all these faces and insetting them individually. I'm going to turn off the individual for now and press Ctrl Z to undo the inset. And now when I press I can actually press I again. And now that's going to allow me to inset individual using a hotkey. I'll press left click to save that. And of course, if you wanted to turn it off again, you could just turn it off in this Inset Faces menu once you're finished and change your mind. Next up we have Select Outer. And when I left click this, you can notice that the faces we now have selected are the ones on the outside. This might be handy if you then wanted to perform an operation on these faces here. So you could quickly do it using this Inset Faces menu here. I'll turn that off for now. Next up we have Outset. It's a little hard to see, but if I increase the thickness, you can see a loop is being pushed along there. And essentially what it's doing is rather than creating a loop inside this face, it's creating a loop on the outside. To better demonstrate this, I'm actually going to add a cylinder. So I'm going to press Shift A, and then I'm going to add cylinder, and I'm going to press G and X to move this cylinder along. This isn't a separate object, it's actually part of this cube since I added it in edit mode, but for now it doesn't really matter. I'm going to press Alt left click, and I'm still in face select mode, which is free on the keyboard, and that's going to select this entire loop here. Then I can press I, and I'm just going to left click because I'm going to change the settings here. So I'm going to turn off the individual option. And you'll see once I have the outset on, when I adjust the thickness, it's actually going to inset that top face instead because it's on the outside of the selected loop. As for this offset relative tool, I don't really tend to use it, so I'm not really going to talk about it today. And yeah, that covers some of the other tools inside of the Inset tool, which I sometimes use. If you want to learn more about the modeling tools like this one and some good fundamentals to getting started with 3D modeling in Blender, I do have a playlist here for absolute beginners, which I'm adding videos to a lot at the moment. Apart from that though, I'd like to thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Take care.